Here comes Speed Racer, he's a demon on wheels. He's a demon and he's gonna be chasing after someone. He's gaining on you, so you better look alive. He's busy revving up the powerful Mach 5. And when the odds are against him and there's dangerous work to do, you bet your life's eraser, see it through. Go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go! He's up and flying as he guns a car around the track. He's jamming down the pedal like he's never coming back. Adventure's waiting just ahead. Go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go!
Had done some fine adjustments on the carburetors of the Mach 5. So I took Spritel and Jim Jim for a drive to test out my racing car.
Yummy, yummy, says my tummy. Hey, look, Speed, it's starting to rain. Jim Jim!
I'll close the cockpit.
Sungalong Prison. The fugitive is the notorious Tung Blaggard. Blaggard is the head of an unscrupulous organization known to have thousands of men throughout the world. At last report, he is thought to be hiding in the vicinity of High Tax Town. Folks, be careful. This man is dangerous.
Look! It's a wonder it runs at all.
That's a famous antique. It's called a Model T.
Who'd want to drive an old junk Jeep like that?
It's not junk.
That's it. Tell him, Grandpa.
His car runs better than a clock.
And I'll bet it doesn't go any faster than a clock.
Keep your eyes on the road ahead. It could be dangerous.
Young man, I can't even see the road ahead.
No roof and no windshield wipers. What a car.
What's that?
Wow, what a temper.
Why not roll the top closed? Then you won't get wet like that, sir.
Why don't you mind your own business?
That old man's stubborn as a mule, right, Jim Jim?
What a car. A hand crank, wooden spoke wheels, a vertical windshield. Let me help you.
You can help me by leaving me alone. Just hop into that junk heap of yours and drive away. There, I've done it.
But now it's stopped raining.
What? Woo!
The sun's coming out. There won't be any more rain.
But I spent half an hour putting up that top. I wish it would keep on raining. But oh, no.
I'm sorry.
Stop laughing. I'm an old man and it's not funny.
It's not very polite to laugh at my grandfather. Shame on you. She was laughing. Come on, Speed. Let's get out of here.
A report on the radio said that an escaped convict is somewhere in this area, so you'd better be very careful.
Thanks for the warning, but an escaped convict doesn't scare me.
He'd better leave us alone, right, Grandpa?
Right, and now you folks leave us alone. Go on, get out of here.
Okay, goodbye, sir. Don't forget Speed's warning. So though they spoke to us like that, I hope they'll be all right. Don't you, Chim Chim?
Later, along with other drivers, I was studying some of the finer points of racing under the instruction of Fireball Rust, one of the greatest racers of all time.
Good work, Speed. You took good advantage of that straightaway. Now, men, get ready for that curve up ahead. Be sure to shift down, and then as you pull out of it, open her wide. Number three, what's the matter with you? You hit the brake too hard and went into that skid. I told you to downshift. Okay, start her up again. From now on, I want you to use just your heel and toe. Remember that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Speed, give her the gun.
Okay, here goes.
You're coming to a curve. Now get ready. Use the brake. You hit the brake too soon.
Sorry.
Now use the clutch. Okay, release the clutch and give her gas. More gas. The engine's not running fast enough. Check the tachometer. Don't use your brake so much. For curves like this, shift a second and let the engine do some of the slowing down.
Speed's driving technique is getting even sharper, and his next race will be soon. With all he's learning from Fireball, he'll have the best chance to win. Where's our picnic basket?
All right, men. Now we're going to practice the way they start at Le Mans. Speed, you'll be the first. Show us how fast you can get your car started.
Yes, sir.
Ready? Go! Faster, Speed. Pick it up! On your feet!
Oh!
Oh! Pull it over! Come on back here! Unknown to Speed, this is his older brother Rex, who ran away from home years ago and is now known as...
Racer X!
Hey!
Hey! Look at him go!
Nobody's as fast as Racer X!
Should be done, man. Nobody can get off to a faster start and maintain top speed as well as Racer X.
Wow. That's fast.
That's really the way to do it, man.
Nobody in the world can beat Racer X.
That's right.
We'll see. I'm going to try my best to be fastest. Tell me you're still mad at Chim Chim, Spritel.
Whenever there's any food around, he won't leave any for me.
Look who's up ahead. You must have a flat tire, but don't worry, I'll have it changed for you in 1 minute.
Here comes that nosy boy again to bother me. Go away! I don't like anybody who drives a new car like yours, young man. They don't appreciate the pleasures of driving with a real stick shift and a real honest-to-goodness clutch.
But that's what I drive with, sir.
Huh? Mmm. Not bad at all. It's got some of the things that my car has.
Oh, what a cute little monkey. You poor thing. You're all tied up. I'll get you loose. There.
Oh! Would you like a ride in the Mach 5?
I'd love it. Thank you, young man.
Okay, sir, come on.
How about both of you riding with me in the old car?
Ah, we'd be happy to. Thanks. Let's go!
What do you think of the Mach 5?
Well, I'll say you're a pretty good driver, young man.
This antique car is my grandpa's treasure.
Oh? It's a pile of junk. Sorry I said that. The car is great.
I'd like you to explain what these buttons are on the steering column.
Well, each one controls a special feature. Anything from jumping over obstacles to driving underwater. There are 7 of them all together, and they were designed and built by my father.
This is a fabulous car, young man, and I must confess I like it. Go ahead, eat as much as you want. There's plenty of food for everyone.
Do all the children here belong to you, sir?
Yes, except for Susie, who's my granddaughter. I've adopted every one of them. At some time or other, each of them needed a home, and I provided it.
That's very kind of you, sir. There should be more people in the world like you.
I'd like to give them a better home, but I don't make much money as a taxi cab washer.
Oh.
Someday, I'll do better for them.
We like you very much, Spreadle. Will you be our friend?
Sure, I'd be very proud.
The whereabouts of the escaped convict Blackguard are still unknown at this hour. Police are on a full-time alert, and all citizens are warned that he's dangerous.
Those cops are wasting their time. They'll never catch me. I'm out of jail forever.
Hey, Mr. Blackguard, look at that. Another Model T.
That gives me another smart idea. I just wonder if that's the same car that used to be owned by Lightfinger's Klepto.
If you drive the Mach 5 in the multi-peak race, I'm sure you'll win, Speed.
Thank you, sir. I'll try.
Oh, you can do it, Speed. Uh-oh. The Model T.
It's gone.
Somebody must have stolen it, Grandpa.
This is terrible.
Oh. I'm sorry, sir.
That car was left to me by Lightfinger's Klepto.
Lightfinger's Klepto?
That famous crook you mean.
Yes. You see, he was my father. It happened 45 years ago. My father was double-crossed by his men. They wiped him out. Just before it was all over, he called me to his bedside and said, "The car." They were his last words. He was bad, a first-class crook, but I loved him because he'd been such a good father. After that, I had nothing but trouble and bad luck, and I was poor. But no matter how poor I became, I hung on to that car because I knew it was what my father had wanted me to do. It was my monument to him. Besides being my one link to the past, that car was my only means of transportation. I've needed it. And what's more, the car served as a playmate for the children. They've loved that car.
Don't worry. I'll try to find out who stole it, and I'll return it.
And I'll help my brother.
Thank you both. I don't want anybody keeping the car.
It shouldn't be very hard to find. After all, there aren't many around like it, so it should be easy to spot.
Do your best, Speed.
I shall.
Hasn't been a single customer for Pops Motors since we opened the factory, and I make the best engines and cars in the world.
Maybe that's the trouble, Pops. Maybe people just don't appreciate a car that's really top-notch.
If business doesn't get better, we won't have enough money even to send Speed to the multi-peak race.
Oh, now cheer up, both of you. I'm sure you'll have lots of customers very soon.
Maybe you're right, but Sparky and I feel we may have to go out of business. Right, Sparky?
Right, Pops.
Have some hot chocolate and cookies.
Thank you, Mrs. Racer. Maybe this'll cheer us up.
Think of all the things we can be grateful for. You have a wonderful factory and garage. Speed and Spreadle are 2 fine sons. All we need to make life really perfect is for Rex to come home again.
Our oldest son was foolish to run away from home.
Maybe I was, Pops. And someday I'll come back. But right now, as Racer X, I'll see that Speed becomes the best racer in the world.
Oh!
This is the Mach 5, Trixie. Come in.
I found the Model T, Speed. It's on Highway 8 near the bridge on the River Quinn.
Good work, Trixie. I'll be there fast as I can.
Let's go, Speed. Come on.
Sounds like a customer.
What can we do for you? Oh, it's you. I thought business was picking up.
Maybe it will, Pops, if you do a little promotion work first so that people will start talking about you.
Promotion work?
Sure, Pops. Public relations is much better than just advertising.
Show folks you're willing to work at below cost.
How can I?
For your first customer, don't charge anything at all.
Right.
Don't charge them anything at all.
If you're really dedicated to your work, you shouldn't think about money.
Okay, it'll be free to the first customer.
Come on in, Mr. Klepto. It's all arranged.
Is that the car? It's a pile of junk.
What do we do with it? Wow. Well, what do you think? The engine's brand new. The old one's in the attic.
Servicing this car is the hardest work I've ever done.
Hey, hurry up! Fix my car!
My car's next!
I've been waiting 3 hours to use the carburetor!
I think the public relations worked.
But do all of our customers have to own Model Ts? What seems to be the trouble with them, Sparky?
Well, I don't know exactly yet, but the trouble's somewhere in their engines.
Every one of them?
I think so.
Seems kind of peculiar that the trouble in all the cars could be the same.
Oh.
Come on, let's go back to your house. Aha!
What's the idea of digging up my old engine, Speed?
Mr. Klepto, someone's trying to get their hands on this engine. There must be a code in these numbers written on it.
Yeah. Those numbers look as if they were etched onto that engine by my father.
Boss, but this isn't the right engine either.
That's funny. I wonder why we can't find the Model T with engine number 9870000. We've got to find the right engine. I don't think that story I heard when I was in prison was a phony. I remember every word that old con told me. You, old man, you're sure shot Slugum. You knocked off Lightfinger's Klepto.
You're right. I'm the one who did the job on Klepto, but I was much younger then. Klepto hid his loot of about $1 million near Boulder Mountain, somewhere in Misty Valley. Engine number 9870000 will lead you to the exact location. However, no one knows where the engine itself is hidden, though I've heard that it hasn't been destroyed.
And just why are you giving me this valuable information?
I'm too old to make use of it myself, so I want to see a younger fellow get the loot. Besides, I've been waiting all these years to hear if Klepto's treasure is really there or not.
Well, thanks for the info, Sure Shot. Hey, come on, you old geezer. Get up. It's time to get up.
I hope that story's true, boss.
Hey, boss, all branches around the world have reported in now. Not one of them has a clue to the right Model T yet.
Find it. Keep searching for that engine till it's found.
Okay, sir.
Strangers are coming.
They are, eh? Why the flag with the number on it?
Let's call it bait and see what we catch.
Bait? It must be a trap set by people who found out we're looking for that engine. So be careful, men. Now man your posts.
It's coming now!
Someone's falling for our trick. They're nibbling at our bait as I thought they would. Hang on!
He's starting to really fly!
Uh-oh, here goes. Another car back there. Find out who you are.
Smart, smart.
We'd better run.
There are only two of them down there and no police around, so let's get them.
They're wasting their bullets on us.
Not far away, Racer X, whom Speed does not know as his older brother, races to the rescue.
How am I going to get down there in time?
Escape the powerful forces of a notorious blackguard? Don't miss the next thrilling episode of Speed Racer.
Go, Speed Racer, go!